there's some very exciting material on the agenda for ACTRIMS this year. First of all, I think it's, you know, it's usually a great meeting, and it's a shame we can't meet in person, but we will be connecting virtually. It provides some vital learning opportunities for trainees. There are several sessions for young investigators, and I think our trainees, unfortunately, have been lacking in some of those opportunities this year, and this meeting should help in that respect. I was excited to see that there were several sessions spotlighting special populations with MS. I think we're really targeting more tailored and personalized therapy in MS. We've learned a lot over the last couple of years about the effects of aging and multiple sclerosis. Disease-modifying therapy, for example, may not be as beneficial in older individuals, and we're learning more about how aging plays into progression. There's also a session devoted to Latin Americans with multiple sclerosis. I think we're learning more about how disability evolves in MS in non-white populations, and that will help us with mitigating racial inequities long-term. I was also excited to see that the European Charcot Symposium was going to be focused on PIRA, or the concept of progression independence of relapse activity in MS. I don't think we know enough about the key early outcome measures that predict long-term disability in MS, and we do have that window within the first 2 years to really optimize our approach to disease modifying therapy, and PIRA may be a key to that. So I'm looking forward to hearing those talks as well. Lastly, I'm co-chairing a session on non-MS CNS inflammatory diseases. This has been an area of tremendous growth in neurology over the last 5 years. So we've seen great advances in neuromyelitis optica spectrum disorder, as well as autoimmune encephalopathies. We have the first evidence-based therapies for NMOSD that are backed by RCT evidence. And I think we're going to see much better outcomes for these diseases in coming years.